Hello and welcome back to part two of our short lecture on an algorithm that can be used for student selection and auctions as well. So in this part, we shall consider the implementation of the algorithm itself using MySQL statements. We have also used the E2 framework to develop our overall application. The challenge to be met remains. That means our implementation should be efficient to the maximum. And the only measure for efficiency here is speed. That means that given a list of the items or batches available and their quotas, plus a list of all bids for these items, we must color all bids as fast as possible and decide the corresponding base values for all items. You can see the tables involved and the fields in this slide. You have the table bids and the table items that are given. The field names there are self-explanatory. In the table bids, we have introduced an extra field, bid. We shall see its usage very soon. And we have done the same thing in the table items, the field item white. The algorithm uses two auxiliary tables as well, the table bay. Its structure is very similar to the table bids and the table bay regulator. We also have a table method to monitor the progress of our algorithm. As already said, our algorithm is actually a while loop, and you go around this loop as long there are white bits left, or as long as you have not reached a maximum number of rounds. So in each round of the loop, you first decide the value of the highest preference ranking for all white bits. And apparently in the first round, dollar min rank equals to one. You then construct a message to inform the user accordingly. And then you construct the algorithm problem as an array of SQL commands that have to be executed. And these are duly executed using the SQL script model that accepts an array of SQL statements and executes them sequentially. And eventually, if you are out of the loop, you just ask if you still have white bits. And if this is the case, it means that you have to rerun the algorithm. There is no need to initialize again. So each time around the loop, you are a bit closer to the solution of the problem. Otherwise, if there are no white bits, it means that you have reached the solution and you just stop. Let's start looking at the MySQL commands. And the first of these will summon the cohorts that you must consider. How you do that? You first find for which items there are white bits with bit rank equal to min rank. And the item ID of these items defines the cohorts to be considered. Then you have to mark all green and white bits of these cohorts ready for transfer to table bay. And here is where the field bit comes to play. And what you do next is you transfer the cohorts in table bay and define the new base values. and the cohorts have to be moved into table bay in close and strict order. And this is achieved by this statement there. Then table bay regulator is used to define which beads in table bay should change their color to green. And you have to decide next the new base value for the corresponding items. And you have to make corrective action at the very end, that if the quota has not been reached, the base value must be set equal to zero for any such item. Finally, you update the color of the beads and get ready for the next round. And you do that by using the table bay as a pivot, so as to update the bead color in table beads. And you can see how the underlying concept in the corresponding slide in part one of the lecture. And here you have a booster statement that you change the color of all beads with bead amount less than the corresponding item base value to red. And that eliminates many beads in each round. And finally, you dismantle your cohorts by setting the bead bit equal to zero. And you are ready now to check whether the termination criteria of the while loop applies. We have successfully tested the algorithm for several sets of data. And in the table below, you see some indicative figures from these runs. We have actually two cases, case A and case B. And here are some thoughts on issues that may affect the performance of the algorithm. The first is quite easy, that the less the number of bits per bidder, the better. And you see the justification for that. Another point that may affect the overall performance of the algorithm is we believe the ratios of the item quotas over the number of bits of bit rank one for that item. And we think the closer these ratios are to one, the easier the task becomes. And finally, you can see a factor that in case all bidders decide to bid for the same batch as the highest ranking bid, and all of them offer the same bid amount, say 1,000, probably the second-hand company will go broke if they stick to their commitment that all bidders with bid equal to the base value of any batch get a car. Before we come to the conclusions, we also think that randomness of bid amounts may affect performance. And we say that because the bids in case A, in the table of run results we have presented, were quite chaotic. And compare that to the situation where all bidders decide to bid a fixed amount for all their bids. And in addition, the amount is more or less different for any two bidders. And that is the case close to case B in the table of run results we have presented. And that's all. We have developed an easy to implement algorithm that can solve the stable marriage problem at hand quite quickly, I think. The question of further improvement remains open. Many thanks for watching.